In this illustration, we intend to simulate Eulerian analysis of the water column collapse in the Abaqus software. In this example, the water column is subjected to the gravity load, causing the water column to collapse and the water to flow down on the ground. In this picture, you can observe the Eulerian area as well as the initial place of the water fluid. The Eulerian domain is a rectangle with a length and width of 10 by 5 meters. This area is actually an area which the water fluid can move in it. Here, the water column has an elevation of 4.5 meters. The area of water has been marked out with blue, while the void area has been displayed by red color in this picture. The void area is indeed the space where there isn't any water. In these pictures, you can observe deformation of the water column in different times. I will enter the Abaqus software for simulation. I will click on Create Part. Here I intend to create the Eulerian part. This question is two-dimensional in terms of nature, but we can't use 2D elements in Eulerian analysis, and only three-dimensional elements may be utilized. So here I'll select 3D, then Eulerian, enter the rough size of the tracing page equal to 50, and continue. First, I'll draw a rectangle, enter its length equal to 10 meters, its width 0.05 meters, done, its depth equal to 5 meters, and OK, in this manner. As mentioned, this question is two-dimensional in terms of nature, but we should use three-dimensional elements when analyzing Eulerian matters, so we have considered the lowest thickness for the Eulerian part. I will select Partition from the Tools menu, then Face and Sketch. I will select this plane down, then select this line. Draw a vertical line. Enter the distance between these two points equal to 2.25 meters. Draw a horizontal line and enter the distance between these two lines equal to 4.5 meters. Done in this manner, then click on Tools menu, select Partition from here, select Extrude Sweep Edge, select this line. Done, select Extrude Along Direction, then select this line and OK, and click on Create Partition. I will select the whole of the model. Done, select this line. Done, Extrude Along Direction, then select this line and OK, and click on Create Partition. In this manner, our model will be converted to four partitions and the water will be placed in this area having been marked out with red color. In the next step, I will enter property module, click on create material. Here, I intend to define the properties of water. I will select density from the general menu, enter the density of water equal to 1000 kilograms per cubic meter, click on mechanical menu, select EOS or the same equation of state. From here select USUP, the speed of sound is 1500 meters per second in the water. I will enter the properties of S and gamma 0 equal to 0. In the next step, I will select the viscosity from mechanical menu. The viscosity of water is equal to 0.001 pascal second and OK. I will click on create section. Select solid, then Eulerian and continue. And OK. I will click on assign section and OK. In the next step, I'll enter assembly module, click on create instance and OK. Then I'll click on translate instance, select the Eulerian part, done. First, I'll select this point, then coordinate system, and OK. I'll enter step module, click on create step, select dynamic explicit, and continue. Time period is equal to 1 second, and OK. I'll enter load module. Click on create load. Here select gravity and continue. I'll enter gravity of Earth equal to -9.81 meters per squared second. Then click on this arrow. Select the whole of Eulerian part. Done. OK. In the next step, I'll click on create boundary condition, select initial step. Here select velocity, angular velocity, and continue. I'll select the surface. Done. Close boundary condition of V2 for it, and OK. I'll click on create boundary condition again, select velocity angular velocity, and continue. I'll select the surface. Done. Close the boundary condition of V1 for it, and OK. Again, I will click on create boundary condition, continue, select the bottom of the model. Done. Close the boundary condition of V3 for it, and OK. The reason why we have selected these boundary conditions is that water does not go beyond the Eulerian range and the water remains in the Eulerian area. Then I will click on create predefined field. Here select other and then material assignment and continue. I'll select Eulerian part, then here I'll select the area where the water is located, done. Here enter number 1. Actually, we have determined the exact place of initial water by doing so, and showed that water has been running through this area. Then I will enter mesh module. Click on seed part, enter approximate global size equal to 0.05 meters and OK. I'll click on mesh part and yes. Then I'll click on assign element type, select the Eulerian part, and done. As you observe, the element library has been placed on explicit and the element family is on Eulerian. Here we don't need to make any special changes, so I'll click on OK. Here I'll save the model. Enter job module, click on create job. Continue. And click on submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I'll click on result. Here I will select EVF Eulerian domain. Here you observe EVF water parameter. If EVF is equal to 1, it means that the element has been filled up with water. And if EVF is equal to 0, it means that there isn't any water in that element, and as it is called, the element is void. The void elements in this question are actually those that are lacking of any water. Here you can observe EVF quantities. As it is observed, EVF is equal to 0 in blue areas, indicating that these areas are lacking of any water. EVF is equal to 1 in red areas, indicating that water has filled up these areas completely. In this question, the water column is exposed to the gravity load, causing that to collapse and start running over the ground. And here you can observe the deformation of the water column. Here the model includes two blue and red colors, showing that there is water in red areas and there isn't any water in blue areas. Here I'll click on View Cut Manager and tick on EVF Void option. In this manner, elements that are lacking of water will be deleted and removed from the model. And here also you can observe the way water is flowing in the area. Here I'll select the velocity contour and then velocity directed at X axis. Here you can calculate the velocity of water flow. The most velocity has been distinguished by a red color. Actually, the column of water flows on the ground due to the weight of water. The void elements in this question are actually those that are lacking of any water.